With the arrival of 5.5, new craftables, the peace love recovers, and catching up on gear, we're now faced with a new and daunting challenge. Poverty. But fret not, together we can fix this. So hello and welcome to the Quick Guild Guide. In this guide, I aim to teach you how to monetize your gameplay loop. We will be covering ways to earn guild by doing roulettes, challenges, and other weekly checkpoints that you might want to be doing regardless, and how to more effectively streamline that process. To this end, we are going to limit ourselves to activities that are reasonably attainable alongside main combat and gearing activities, and therefore, we will not go into major side quests, crafting, or gathering. So, first thing first, what are you going to need to be able to follow this guide? This is quite simple. All you need is a combat class at level 80. This is because if you do your roulettes with a class at max level, you will receive various items and a bit more gil for its completion instead of experience. This is further enhanced if you queue as that roulette's adventurer in need class. The role in need tends to be either healer or tank, can also be DPS, most often in alliance raids. The easiest way to cover all three bases would be to start out as an arcanist, which is the base for both Scholar and Summoner, then pick up Gunbreaker, which starts out at level 60. This is possibly the fastest way to get a tank, healer, and a DPS all to 80. So now that you're ready to queue as in need, why do we do this? Essentially, the Adventurer in Need bonus will see you off with increased skill rewards, increased Grand Company seal rewards, as well as cracked Stella and Planning Clusters that can be exchanged for grade 7 and 8 materia, while also rewarding you with two kinds of tombstones, which can be spent on gear upgrades and items. Though the total guild reward will vary based on a roulette, if you queue in need, the total reward per roulette seems to average in at roughly 15,000 gil per first daily completion. If you want to maximize your reward per time spent, I would advise doing the Alliance Raid roulette as well as the Leveling roulette. The reason for this is that the Leveling roulette should reward more gil than the average, reward Grand Company seals, and the two of them both reward a cracked Stella cluster, which, based on the current server prices, can be spent on materia valued between 4 and 15,000 gil per materia, potentially doubling your daily reward. Depending on the groups, this should take anywhere between 40 and 80 minutes per day on average, and should also let you reach your weekly cap on tombstones and give you enough Grand Company seals for materials to stock or sell. Typically, Grand Company materials will vary violently on a market board from server to server, so scout around a little bit before you buy. But after a week of doing this, you should sit on roughly 250,000 to 300,000 gil worth of materia, gil, and materials. Furthermore, doing this should check off some challenges in your challenge log. If you complete 5, 10, 15, 20, and 30 challenges, you will get an additional 10,000 gil per increment, with an additional 5,000 on the final one, for a grand total of 55,000 in addition to any gil you get from the individual challenges. A few quick ones include the Golden Sorcerer tab, the Wondrous Tales, Player Commendations, Fates, Guild Hests, and Dungeons. If you want to go the extra mile, make sure to need and greed items in the instances you do, as you can turn them into Grand Company for seals, or desynthesize them for sellable materials if you have that skill unlocked. In order to unlock it, need a crafter or gatherer at level 30, and you can do the quest Gone to Pieces, which you can unlock here. Regardless of the method you choose, you should be left with a fair few materials to sell from this as well. Do keep in mind, however, that other players might need these to gear, so if someone mentions needing a piece, and you do not need it yourself, it doesn't hurt to show some courtesy. Finally, in order to be able to sell all of your materia, materials and items, you're going to need a retainer. In order to get retainers, you will have to have completed the Science of the Seventh Dawn, as well as an ill-conceived venture, after which you should be able to talk to one of the three retainer vocates who reside in the market sections of the three main cities. Once you've gone through the process of setting up your retainers, you can make them sell your items on a market board, and in a menu, you can check the current prices of said items as well. A few rules of thumb would be to not crash the market, as that damages everyone's profit potential over time. Do not list an item for less than you can sell it for to a vendor. Sell bulk items in stacks of 10 to 20 instead of dumping an entire 99 stack on there, as it can deter some buyers. So following these three tips, and assuming a middle-of-the-line profit and completion rating, how much are we looking at? You should be sitting on at least 250,000 gil from leveling and alliance-rated roulettes, 20 to 30,000 gil from challenge logs, and 10 to 15,000 from pickups and bulk sale materials. Altogether, this should equal at least 280,000 gil per week. It might not seem like a lot, but there's a skill you can make from just playing the game, with the added benefit of stemming from activities that you might already be doing in order to improve and upgrade your gear. It adds up, and could even see you with enough gil to buy you a plot and some furniture once the Ishgard residential district becomes available. Hopefully, this guide might have taught you something useful. If you want more content like this, feel free to subscribe and leave any questions or comments down below. As always, I wish you all a great day and a great week. Have a nice one!